right. So we have seen basically the analysis is going to be in what, two parts. One is quantitative and the other one is qualitative. So we'll see that one by one. Right, first one. Analysis of differential pair. So first is, what is the meaning of differential? So here this is my V1 and this is V2 RD V01 V02 and this we have already seen, this ISS is a current. Now we will apply two supplies here just for the sake of it. I'll call it as the V1 and here I'll just draw V2. Okay. So the objective here is to find out what is the effect of V1 on V01 and V02. So objective, number one is to find effect of V1 on V01 and V02, and second is to find effect of V2 on V01 and V02. Are you understanding? So these are the two things that we want to find out. What is the effect of V1 on V01 and V02? And what is the effect of V2 on V01 and V02? Then what we will do is, third step, let's say, apply superposition and let's say add the responses. Apply superposition and add the response. So you see the effect of V1 on V01 and V02, which simply means you will make V2 0 when you are analyzing the effect of V1, and then you will keep this 0 and apply, see the effect of V2. But actually, if you see, we have, if you do one, you can generalize the second one. That is the beauty of it. Okay? You don't have to completely solve it. Even if you solve for one, second one we can generalize. Okay. So, right. Have you written like this? Write it. So, out of this, one will definitely come. That is your quantitative analysis in common mode or differential mode, and the other question is qualitative analysis of differential or common mode. So last time what we did, one out of that normally comes, and one out of what we will do today will come, and there will be some sums also. Okay, right? Case one. Case one. To observe the effect of case one, to observe the effect of V in one, make other sources zero. Make other sources zero. So what is the meaning of that? Make other sources zero means what? So this is okay, right? So what is our case one? So I'll write here, making V into is zero. That's the first thing. So other sources means what? Even and ISS will also be equal to V. ISS will also be equal to zero. In fact, even VDD has to be equal to zero, but we will make zero one by one. Okay, so we will break that down into many steps, and ultimately we will say, look, now everything is zero. Current sources are also zero and voltage sources are also zero. So this is not a complete AC model what you are going to see. A part of it I'll first convert to AC, and then again some part again to AC, so that simplification becomes realizable. Okay, so here now what I do is, next diagram we will draw like this. I have R, then I have got same, what is this, V in one, then I have got another resistance here, RD, VDD, and V into equal to zero. And now what you will have to do is, we will write here ISS is equal to what? Zero. So first, this is the thing that we want to do. What we have not made zero is VGD for now. Other two we have made it to what? Zero. Now I can take this further. So I'll call this as M1, M2, M1 and M2. So I'll replace this M2 by the AC module. So now see how I do it. Here I have got RD, mean one. Then here I will have to show what? Open circuit, na? Because ISS is zero means what? Current source value is zero means open circuit. Then we have a resistance, and then we can also draw one current source like this. One R I will draw, and this is point X, and that gate is connected to our ground. So this is GM2, VGS2. What is this? Plus minus 1 by GM2. This is drain, gate, and this is what? Do you agree with this? Yes or no? This is which model of the MOSFET? T. So normally we show like this, but now I have shown it doesn't matter. I have still maintained what? Node X. Yes or no? So I decomposed this M2 into the AC module. So first what I did, I made ISS 0. Then I connected this to ground. Now since I want to ultimately do AC analysis, I am converting M2 into what? An AC system. So that is AC equivalent of the M2. Now you can observe here one very typical thing. This is what? Drain, source. And here we have already named the drain and the source and the gate. So what happens here is now, in this case, if you look at this, this is what? VDD. So we have a resistance RD. Then you have got what? M1. Then you can see one by what? GM2. But node X is connected to what? Ground. So as such, this circuit has nothing to do with this side of the circuit. Why? Because in between there is a ground. This current will never flow here. It will always flow to ground. Are you understanding this part? Yes or no? So common sense tells me that this circuit will further be, we can draw it like this. So this is my M1. What were you having here? V01. Here you are having V02. So don't forget that V01 and V02. And then here you have 1 by GM2. Do you agree with this? 1 by GM. Now, is it not like a CS stage? This is like what? A CS stage with degenerative feedback. So, you have a CS amplifier whose source is slightly above the ground. So, what will be the gain of such an amplifier? Calculate it. Come on, do it. Or what I'll do is I'll just go one step ahead and here I'll draw the AC equivalent of this circuit. What is this? V01. And here you are applying V in 1. So actually, if you see this circuit, the AC model of this circuit is this circuit. But we went from the circuit to its AC analysis in some steps. That's it. Are you understanding? Because directly by just looking at this, it is difficult to realize this. Are you understanding the point? So that's why we went in steps. So very easily you can write here now, V0, V01 is equal to how much? Minus GM1 VGS1 RD. And V in 1 is equal to how much? V in 1 will be equal to how much? 1 by GM1 plus 1 by, that is the resistances, into what is the value of current? GM1 VGS1. So what will be V01 by VIN1? What will be V01 by VIN1? V01 by VIN1 is equal to how much? Minus, so GM with this will cancel out. So I'll get minus RD upon 1 by GM1 plus 1 by GM. This is one equation that we get. Right? So what we calculated right now is V01 under the influence of VIN1, but we want to also calculate what is V02 under the influence of VIN1. So we could calculate V01 is what? RD into VIN1 upon 1 by GM1 plus 1 by GM2. But what about V02? Because ultimately I want the differential signal V01 minus V02. So, right, calculation of V02. Are you understanding this point? So now we have calculated V01 in terms of VIN1. Now we want to calculate V02 in terms of VIN2. So calculate. Come on, do it. So you can start from here and generalize. So see here what I am doing. I am starting from here, V02. I want V02, no? So, we have got, this is V02. Then, between V02 and VDD, which is going to be what? Ground, AC-wise, there is what? RD. So, I will show one RD. Then what do we have? The same V02 is connected to what? M2. So that is another transistor there, which will be like this. So this is GM2, VGS2. Okay. And in between there is a node X. And that is connected to what? 0. That is connected to what? 0. So that is connected to ground. What is this? 1 by GM2 plus minus VGS. Is it okay? So we have come now from where? Drain, source. But here, when we came here, ISS is what? 0. So that will be open circuit. So directly you are going to see what? Source of M1. Source of M1 means, now we will see something like this. 1 by GM1 VGS1. And here, this is the node X of this circuit, and here you are applying what? VIN1, IG equal to 0, and then here we have ID. Okay. So now what I want is, I want relationship between V in 1 and V02. So some KVL should give me that. So V02 is very straightforward. What is that? Minus RD into GM2 VGS2. Minus RD into what? GM2. Just find out what is the value of V in 1. So this is actually drain source, this is the source of this gate drain. Are you understanding this? Yes or no? Okay, so what's the value? So you can always say by common sense many things, right? So here, V02, what is the value of that? Minus GM2 VGS2 into RD. Yes or no? This current will flow through what? This RD, and the voltage drop across it is V02. And V in 1, so this voltage, can we say, is being applied between this point and ground? Yes or no? And what we have here is GM2 VGS2. So if you look at this current source, it is going to flow in the opposite direction. So that's why what we'll get here is V in 1. So what are the resistances between this point and ground? 1 by GM1 and 1 by GM2. Now if you are taking this, then the current will be taken as positive. But if you are taking this, then the current will be taken as negative. So if you are taking GM1 VGS1, then the voltage drops across this will be what? Positive. But why? Because this current is flowing like this to ground. But this current is going to flow in the opposite direction. That's why the voltage drop is going to be minus. Something like this. And now when you take the ratio, you are going to get the value of gain or V02 by V01. If I wanted to write here in terms of this one, because here this current and this current are the same. One has to be the negative of the other. So if you are using the first one, you use the negative one, GM2 VGS2. If you want to write in terms of GM1 VGS1, we'll write here positive. But GM1 VGS1 is of no use to us, right? Because ultimately we want to cancel out with GM2, and that's why I am using the first one. You can also say I use GM1 VGS1, no problem, but then they should cancel out. That's the main thing. Okay. So what will you get? So of course the negative sign will go away. Yes or no? So what you will get here is V02 upon V in 1. What is that? RD upon 1 upon GM1 plus 2, right or not? Okay, good. So D this equation I can also write into what? V in 1, and this equation I can write what? Into V in 1. Right? So now what is V01 minus V02? V01 minus V02 is going to be how much? Minus 2 times of RD, 1 by GM1 plus 1 by GM2 into what? V in 1. Therefore, V01 minus V02, I'll write here, due to V in 1 is going to be what? Can we write like this? This is the difference due to what? V in 1, because only V in 1 is present. So now can you also find out V01 minus V02 due to V in 2? Can you do that? Come on, do it. V01 minus V02 due to this is what? V in 1. Now I will find out due to what? V in 2, and then I'll add the response. Then I'll do what? That is due to both V in 1 and V in 2. That's the beauty of superposition. Barar ki nahi? So superposition is a very strong theorem. In BW, you always feel it is so difficult to do. Apply the same thing 3-4 times. KVL case here also you have to apply 3-4 times in every case. So what can come in 2 steps actually requires a lot of time with superposition. But in such circuits, superposition is very strong. So what will you do? Here, V in 1, I'll make it what? 0. So you can just call this as V02, V01, like this. And this is what? Same thing, no? And this is become what? 2 and 1. Yes or no? Instead of redrawing everything, I just replaced M1 by M2. Now M1 gate has to be equal to what? 0, and this V into has to be something, right? So here also, now what I'll get is GM1, VGS1, this will be 1, this will be 2, okay? Then we have here V into M2, V02. And here you will get what? GM1. And here also you will get same thing. GM1, GM2, V into, GM2, VGS2, V02. And now you will get here V02 is equal to GM2 Barare. And here V02 will be minus of, agree? Yes or no? Okay, so some changes here also. So So now we will write here V01, then 1, 1. This will be 2. And what you should get here is V01. This is as it is. And what will you get here? Do you agree with this? Now what will you get? So can you see here you got V02 first, but we always want what? V01 minus. We don't want now to shift it. So that's why this whole thing I can now generalize. V01 minus V02 is equal to 2 times of RD. Right or not? This minus the first one. So minus minus will become plus. So please note here you are getting what? Minus 2RD. Here you are going to get plus 2RD upon 1 by GM1 plus 1 by GM2 into or we can write V01 minus V02 due to V2 is 2RD V2 upon 1 by GM1 plus 2. Do you agree with this? So this is the response due to V1. This is the response due to, now add by superposition theorem. What will you do? Add. So will it be 0? It will not be 0. V1. Yes or no? Yes or no? So you should have good eyes. And to have good eyes, what should you do? What you should do? Caret and don't use phone. Apples. Okay. So use glasses. Anyways, in VLSI everything is small only. So you should have the habit of looking at it properly. I think the project review has got a good effect on the attendance. Yes or no? I think suddenly everybody has realized what all things are pending. And I think they have all calculated the time and what has to be delivered within the time. And I think the results are amazing. Okay. Good. So I always do this in the end. I never review the project beforehand. Normally, I'll leave this thing to the guides. Okay. Right. So, if you add this, what will I get? I will write V01 minus V02 due to both V1 and V2. What will it be? What will it be? So I'll get here V01 minus V02 is equal to, what will I get? Minus 2RD into V in 1 minus V in 2 upon 1 by GM1 plus 1 by GM2. Yes or no? And if you take this V in 1 on the other side, what you should get is something like this. That is V01 minus V02 upon V in 1 minus V in 2. Well, again, is what? 2RD upon 1 by GM1 plus 1 by GM2. So this is differential output upon differential input. Differential output upon. So if you go to the, go back to qualitative analysis of differential mode, go back. So we have drawn one waveform there, input output characteristics. That was also V01 minus V02 on y axis, and on x axis what was there? V in 1 minus. So now somehow we were able to find out the relationship between the two, and we actually found out what was the slope of that graph. That is equal to what? 2RD upon 1 upon GM1 plus 1 upon GM2. So the moral of the story here is that the differential gain is twice of RD minus of this upon 1 upon GM1 plus 1 upon what? 1 upon GM1 plus 1. So this is the value of differential gain. If GM1 is equal to GM2, then what is the value of gain? If GM1 is same as GM2, then AD will be what? Minus GM1 or GM2 times of RD. Are you understanding? So this GM would be GM1 or GM2. So it comes down to what again? Something like CS only. Something like CS amplifier, provided the transistors are symmetric. Okay. Or their W by L ratios are the same. So this is like a 10 marks derivation in the exam. And if they ask you qualitative analysis, then you show input output characteristics. But if they ask quantitative analysis, then you have to derive the equation for gain in the differential. Are you understanding this? It's pretty simple if you do it slowly. You should be able to arrive. Okay. So have you taken down the second part? Ye second draw kiya? Draw kiya ki nahi? Karo. Okay, second part also you have to draw. In the exam, if you are not having time, you can just skip it. But you can, after drawing this once, you can write similarly like this. But actually they are not similar. This has got a minus sign. This doesn't have a minus sign. So, okay, we will give you the benefit of doubt of saying similarly here. And then you can add. Okay. Superposition means always what? Addition of the response. Some students also apply a brain in a different way. They subtract. So superposition is always addition of the response. It is never the differential response. It is always the addition of the individual response. That's why we have to add. This is due to V1. This is due to V into. Due to both will be this. Okay. Right. In the circuit given below, M2 is twice as wide as M1. Calculate the differential gain of the amplifier. So what they are saying now is W by L1 is not equal to W by L2. They have written what? M2 is twice as wide as M1. So solve for that and determine the gain. Come on, do it. So the problem is somewhat like this. So this is given to us. Okay, now this transistor has got W by L1, and this is what one, and this is W by L2. So what they have given is M2 is twice as wide as M1. So let's write this W by L1 is just W by L for the time being, and M2 is twice as wide as M1, means what? Length remains the same, but width doubles. What is the meaning of that? This will be 2W upon L. Okay. Now what they are asking us, calculate AD. What is the formula for AD? Minus of 2RD upon 1 by GM1 plus 1 by GM2. So this is my generic formula, right? GM1 and GM2 can be anything. So gain wise, okay, it is, it, you will get some value, but actually if you go and simulate this in the lab, you will get a weird response. V01 and V02 will not be same. The DC levels in both of them will be different, so which doesn't give you exact cancellation, and the output also goes for a talk. Okay, but it will give you some value of gain. So in this sum, they are not accounting for what is the shape of the signal, and when you take a difference, what will happen. Such things are not there. They just want to see how you apply the formula to calculate the gain. Okay, so calculate, very simple. How will you solve this? So let's say this is I1. What is this? I2, and obviously ISS will always be what? I1 plus I2. So that's my first equation. That is, ISS will always be equal to I1 plus I2. Now what is given to us is the different W by L. So what you will do is, here I'll write GM1 is equal to, what is GM1 formula wise, root of 2 mu n COx W by L1 into what? ID1? Yes or no? And GM2 formula wise, it is going to be 2 mu n COx W by L2 times of I. These are the formulas for the values of GM1 and GM. So now what will you do? So let us say these transistors are in saturation, otherwise they will not amplify, right? So it is okay to assume that they are in saturation. So what is ID1 or I1 is what? Mu n COx by 2 W by L1 is what? W by L into VGS1 minus VTH1 the whole square, and I2 will be mu n COx by 2 W by L2 VGS2 minus VTH2 the whole square. So if you take a ratio of this, VGS1 is equal to VGS2. Yes or no? Yes or no? Okay, so we are applying the same signals at the gate. So gate voltages are same and the sources are shorted. So even source voltages are the same. So what you get here is I1 is equal to, or I1 upon I2 is W by L1 upon W by L2. Please note, they are not current mirrors. Okay. Every time you write this formula, it doesn't mean that they are current mirrors. It is coming from some different condition. Okay. What is the condition? That your V in 1 is the same as V in 2. Okay. So here, obviously, I'll write I1 upon I2 is what? W by L upon twice of W by L. So I2 is equal to what? Twice of I1. Yes or no? So if I2 is twice of I1, I'll write, put I2 in this equation. So what will I get? ISS is equal to I1 plus 2I1. That is going to be what? 3 times of I1. Therefore, I1 is equal to ISS by 3. This also implies I2 will be equal to what? 2 ISS by 3. Do you agree with that? If I1 is ISS by 3, I2 will be what? ISS minus ISS by 3. That will be what? 2 ISS by 3. Understood? Yes or no? Okay. So now you know W by L1 and you know W by L2. And now you also know I1 and I2. Now you also know what? I1 and I2. So you can multiply them out. So GM1 will now be root of 2 mu n COx W by L into I1 is how much? ISS by 3, and GM2 is root of 2 mu n COx 2 W by L into 2 ISS by 3. So what will be GM1 upon GM2? GM1 by GM2 would be one upon root of 4, 1/2. So GM2 is twice of GM1, or GM1 is GM2 by 2. So you can put this one, GM1 is equal to twice of GM2 here, or you can put GM2 is GM1 of by 2. So this is going to be, therefore AD is equal to minus 2RD upon GM2 is basically 1 upon GM1 plus 1 upon twice of GM1. So that 2 will go up, and what we'll get here is minus 4/3 RD. This is one formula, and the second one you will get here is AD is equal to minus 2RD upon 1 upon GM1 plus will be 2 by GM2, 1 by GM2. So AD is equal to minus 2 by 3 Understood? So this is the value of your gain. Now this question, if you see, has come thrice in the paper. Okay, till now it comes every year in the paper. So it is very important with respect to your second test also. You will get something similar in the exam. Now what you do is, you do this. Instead of twice W by L, let's do thrice W. They can give you thrice also, right? Yes or no? Now, can you solve this for gain? So, in the exam, you do only one. AD in terms of GM1 or GM2. When I am checking, I will have both the answers. Somebody might do it in terms of GM1 or GM2. So, that's fine. Okay, they are linked, na? GM1 and GM2, if you are able to show me a relation, if you are able to come till here and then you solve any one, it is okay. Because we already know the relationship between GM1 and GM2. Okay, so this sum comes for 10 marks in the exam. So how many marks now? 30 marks. If you do what we did in the last three lectures, then that is going to come for around 30 marks. Which is a pretty good amount of straightforward sum, right? But what will come in the IA is not very straightforward. It will be very weird. So solve for this 3W by L. What will you get? I think here you will get what? What will you get here? You will get here 3. Here I think you will get, what will you get? 3 by 4 and 1 by 4. Then you find out this 3 by 4 ISS and 1 by 4 ISS. Put it here and get done. Solve karo. One sum is already there. in front of you. So let's practice it here only. Everybody gets at least 10 marks in the main exam. I cannot guarantee about IA. IA will be tough because if you do well in the IA, it also implies that you will do well in the main exam. But if you do well in the IA, it doesn't mean that you will also do well in the main exam. So testing and training cannot be on the same data. Those who are doing projects on neural network or artificial intelligence will understand this better. So those who are present today will not have to give the quiz, okay, but those who are absent today will have to give a extra quiz whose marks will be of course included in your term work, and the quiz will be online and it will start at 11 in the night and it will end at 11:30. Okay, so how is the response from your parents? Must be really interesting. They might be feeling, my son or daughter is studying in the night when you are doing the Moodle submission. Yes or no? They might be feeling, Urmila is studying in the night. They have become so sincere. I have never seen her like this in all her engineering. Yes or no, Urmila? So in a way, I am creating good impression of you in front of your own parents. So you can say thank you to me. At least I am making you look good and sincere in front of others. But parents know exactly what you are, so you can't fool them. Is it okay? Solve this. And so first you will solve only with 3WL and then you will solve by this. Both are some different ratio. Okay. In the exam, I'll put something like 72 WL upon 49 WL. Okay, some weird one. Whatever comes to my mind, I'll just put it. But the method remains the same. Do you agree or you don't agree? The method remains the absolutely same. No change in the method. So what answers you are getting? So I think this will become 3. For this, not with 5. For this one, so here it becomes 3, 4, this will become 4, this will become what? 3 by 4, this 3 by 4, so this will become what? Root 9. And then you solve all. What will you get here? Six by four. Here you will get what? Minus six by four, na? And here you will get 2 by 4. Here you will get 1. This 2 by 4. Okay. What? What? Somebody said something. Yes, here, right? And here also it will be 3. Just for the capture sake, this answer has got recorded, right? Now you really have to look at this one, pi w by l and p w. Come on, do this and tell me what is the answer. Come on, next one, pi w by l and 3 w by l. So are you understanding? Any ratio given to you, you should be able to solve. And you can come and see your IA mark whenever you feel like coming. If you feel like coming. If you have really written something in the IA paper and if you wish to discuss on it, you can come and see the paper. Okay. It will be there with me for some time and on one day just I'll go and give it to exam. Okay. ये कौन पिता है? ये क्या है? This, what is this? Okay, solve it fast, come on. And then we will see the analysis of common mode. It's very quick. And then we'll stop. And next time when we come, I'm going to introduce OPAM. So all have to be there because there is a 20 marks question on that. And there are some analysis also on OPAM. So to understand that, you must be in class. Done. For 5W by L is also done. So whatever that answer is, you write it. I may ask something similar in the exam with any weird ratio of W by L. Done. Right. Next. Common mode response. Common mode response. So when you applied only different signals, you got some gain, right? And now we want to apply same signals on both sides. So we can no longer write these gains. Maybe you can keep W by L 1 and 2. And this will still be I1 is equal to what? Or ISS is equal to I1 plus I2. Now, common mode response means what? Your V in 1 must be equal to V in 2, common mode. So that is, instead of writing V in 1 and V in 2, what will I write? VCM, and this is also what? VCM. And we have already seen VCM is what? V in 1 plus V in 2 by 2, right? And in the differential mode, that is V in 1 minus V in 2 by 2, and the other one will be minus of V in 1 minus V in 2 by 2. So those are the voltages which you are actually applying at the gate. So sometimes this V in 1, V in 2 can be confusing. So you can just write VCM and VCM. That's also just fine. You are applying what? Same signals at the gate of both the transistors. Right? An important attribute of differential amplifier. An important attribute of differential amplifier is their ability to suppress. Is their ability to suppress the effect of common mode variation. Is their ability to suppress the effect of common mode variation. Full stop. In reality, neither a circuit is fully symmetric. In reality, neither a circuit is fully symmetric, nor does the current source, nor does the current source exhibit, nor does the current source exhibit an infinite input impedance, exhibit an infinite input impedance. Right. Practically, the above circuit is as follows. Practically, the above circuit is as follows. So if I draw now like this, I think you should not be surprised. What is this? IRF. What is the current flowing through this? ISS. Yes or no? So I'll call this as M3 and this as M4, and what is the value of ISS? ISS will be W by L3 upon W by L4 into IRF. So this is very important. Into what? IRF. Yes or no? That's what you get. And what is the voltage at this point? So let's call this as VB. And VB is equal to root of 2IRF upon mu n COX W by L of 3 into plus VTH. divide of 2. So you can quantify everything. The voltage at this point is this. Why? Because this transistor is always in saturation. So you can apply the condition for saturation and get this answer. This VB is also what? VGS. So VGS is equal to root of 2 IRF upon mu n COX plus VTH. Now what is the meaning of that is that both M3 and M4 are in saturation. So if they are in saturation, then my characteristics in saturation is like this. This is linear and this is going to be what? Saturation. Now here the slope is very high, but this is ID and what is this? VDS. So here the resistance will be low and here the resistance will be high. Now M3, this M3 is in what? Saturation. Yes or no? M3 will be in. So it will offer which resistance? High resistance or low resistance? High resistance. Ideally, it should offer how much? Infinitely high resistance. But it's a transistor. So it can have some CLA. It can. So we are just saying that that value is high. Ideally, it is what? Infinite. So actually this M3 is offering a very high resistance value. Barabar ki nahi? M3 is offering a very high resistance value. Okay. What to do? Here. So based on that, we will now find out what is the common mode gain. So this circuit can now become like you are just playing with the circuit. You are having here what? N1 and then here same thing M2. Now this M3 is behaving as a what? High resistance. So let's say that ISS is offering a resistance of RS. So this RSS is only indicative. Are you understanding? This RSS is only what? There is no physical resistance here. This is just indicative. So this is maybe arising because lambda is not equal to 0. If lambda is 0, then what? It's like an open circuit. So let's see what happens. Here we are giving what? VCM, VCM, M1, M2, V01, V02, RD, RD. Okay. Can you see you are giving same inputs at both the places? So output should also be same. Yes or no? If the inputs are same, the output should also be same. Who said 0? V01 is equal to V02. That's what we are saying. Okay, because VCM same input, same source input for both the transistors and both the signals are now same. They are not 180 degrees phase shifted. They are in phase. So can I say V01 is equal to V02? Right? Since the same signals are applied at the gate, since the same signal is applied at the gate, owing to symmetry, voltage at point X is equal to voltage at point Y. That is V01 equal to V02. That is what V01 is equal to V02. Therefore, the above circuit can be drawn as follows. Vx is equal to what? Vy. So, I will short the terminal. Barar ki nahi? Vx is equal to always what? Vy in common mode. So, it is as good as those points are shorted. Draw like this. So, it is as good as the terminals are shorted. So, draw another. Don't show him the same thing because step by step we are doing the evaluation. Are you understanding this? Because if there is symmetry, then Vx will be equal to Vy. So this circuit now can be further drawn like this for the record. This is RSS. This is actually what? M1 in parallel with M2. What is M1 parallel to M2? Do resistance in series to suna hai. Do transistor, sorry, parallel suna hai. But what is two transistors in parallel? What it means is drain of this transistor is shorted with drain. Source is source and gate voltages are same. Na? So even gate is shorted to gate. So when you keep one transistor on another, that's what we mean by they are in parallel. Okay. Or that is drain and source and gate. Can you see this RD? This R is going to be what? RD parallel with RD. How much is that? RD by 2. I don't know for M2, but you can make it. What is the meaning of that? Here I have got 2. So I am taking T model. Gm2 VGS 2 plus minus 1 by GM2 like this, and I am having one more here like this, and this is X, this is gate, GM1 is this one. So if I short this, this and this, you know, in BW you get sums like this, two current sources in parallel, and then they'll ask you what is equivalent resistance between this point, or realize a current source in parallel with a resistance, or voltage source in parallel with sums of those sorts, right? So actually we don't realize that time what all this thing is, but such circuits actually come. So what does it mean? And there are two resistances in parallel. So this thing we can write now like this, and this is my, let's say, V0, V out, and this is what? VCM. So now here I have resistance which is RD by 2. This is not VCD. V out. Okay. Then you come to this parallel combination. So what I am doing is, I am drawing only one effect. So this is VCM. And here the question is, what should I write on this current source and what should I write on the other one? Barar ke nahi? So VGS1 is equal to VGS2. Why? Because VGS1 is VG minus VS, that is VCM minus VP, and VGS2 is also what? VCM minus VP. That's why you can say that VGS1 is equal to VGS2 equal to some VGS. So this VGS1 and VGS2 are the same and the current sources are in parallel, so you can add them. So the value of this current source would be GM1 plus GM2 into V. Are you understanding? Parallel, na? In between there is a gate from here. What is this? Drain, and this is source. Yes or no? And now this one by GM2, then we have RSS, that's the AC equivalent of this one. So all this is not required. Are you getting this? Samajh gaya, what is the meaning of M1 parallel to M2? So just if there are three, then three in parallel means what? 1 by GM1 parallel to 1 by GM2 parallel to 1 by, but of course 3 would not mean any sense here because in differential there are only 2. And this would become what? GM1 plus GM2 plus GM3. So this is what Microwind does, that if it wants to increase the gain of the or the GM of the transistors, then instead of making one transistor, it makes two transistors in parallel. That is what is the meaning of that. Are you understanding? If you want to boost the GM of the transistor, you can put two transistors in parallel. That's a nice way, right? So now you find out the relationship between VCM and Vout. So Vout is very straightforward. Vout will be what? Minus RD2 into what? GM1 plus GM2 some VGS. Here also we'll write VGS, and VCM is equal to, the resistances will be what? 1 by GM1 parallel to 1 by GM2 plus RSS, that's the total resistance, into the current will be how much? GM1 plus GM2 into VGS. So now you take the ratio of this thing. So these two will straight away get cancelled, and what you get, you write. So what will you get? V out by VCM is equal to minus RD upon 2, 1 upon GM1 parallel to 1 upon GM2 plus Ra. Yes or no? Now, if the transistors are symmetric, GM1 is equal to GM2 is equal to some GM, what you will get here is Vout by VCM is what? Common mode gain. That is what? ACM or AC. That is going to be minus of what will you get? RD by 2 upon 1 upon 2 GM plus R. Right? What is the meaning of this? If I am able to make a ideal transistor M3, my lambda will be equal to what? 0. So if my lambda is 0, RSS will tend to infinity and my common mode gain will be what? 0. So I want my common mode gain to be small. I don't want that noise, if any, at the input should get amplified. Are you understanding? I don't want noise to get amplified. But that's not going to be the case. Why? Because all this is practical thing. So we will always get some value of what? RSS. Yes or no? So your common mode gain will always be something. It can never be equal to 0. And that is the problem. And what is the actual problem? So now you know CMRR is what? AD upon AC. CMRR should be very high, or typically it should be infinite. So for it to be infinite, my AC should be what? 0. What if AC is not 0? My CMRR will come down. So I have to always ensure that my RSS is tending to infinity, and RSS is the impedance offered by the transistor in saturation. And so if this slope is perfectly flat, which will happen only if lambda equal to 0 or lambda tends to 0. So in the Viva, they may ask you that if you make bigger transistors, you will get CMRR which tends to infinity. If you try to make the transistors smaller, your CMRR is going to become lesser and lesser. Are you understanding this thing? So now do you understand why the size has to be bigger in size? Of all the transistors, the size has to be big, simply because this PLM is simply too much to handle. You may argue, okay, I will make size small, I'll use cascading. Instead of M3, M4, I'll use also M5 and M6. No problem, but you are raising this point above ground, which is twice of VDS1. So the amount of voltage swing available here is less. So there will be a problem of what? Voltage headroom. So the voltage swing will get affected. So you are trying to design a high gain amplifier, but you are getting low voltage swing. What's the use? Can you call it high gain then? You can't. So that's the issue there. So cascading will not really solve the problem. It will make this RSS high. In fact, it will make this RSS very high. Okay, so your CMRR would increase like anything, but your gain will get affected. Your differential gain might be less. What is the meaning of this CMRR? Let's say gain is initially 10 and this is tending to 0. What is this? Infinite. Now I say you use cascode. Cascode means what? This will still be very high, But this will now come down. So actually, if you see this ratio, CMRR still says infinite. But if you look at only AD, AD comes down. Okay. So CMRR is not a measure of noise as such. SNR is, that is signal to noise. So the signal to noise ratio can get affected, but CMRR would still come out to be high. Now, do you understand this is all too much to look at? In digital design, we were looking only at what? Area, speed and power. Here power to hum dekhi nahi rahe. Jitna chahiye de do, aisa. Area bhi mat dekho, jitna chahiye. Give how much ever area you want, but give me first linear amplification. Okay, so that is my primary concern. What is the primary concern? The gain has to be proper. My CMRRs have to be proper. Why? Because in the op amp, you must have seen like this, something like this, plus and minus, V1 and V2. So this is my difference signal. I call it as VID or VD. So what is Vout? Vout will be AD into VD plus AC into. So we want that Vout should be only this. So what is the meaning of that? This is AD VD into 1 plus AC upon VC AD VD. But what is AC upon AD? 1 by CMRR. So if CMRR is tending to infinity, then only this term will become 0. And that's when V out will be AD into. So to bring true meaning to the op amp, all it comes down to is just designing what again? ISS. And ISS is designed from what? IRF. So everything is linked to design of current mirrors and current source. So that doesn't mean that you can do whatever you want with it, but in general everything is linked to the current source design. So do that very well as far as the exam is concerned, because everywhere I go this only will come. Even in the op amp, same thing, same deal. Okay, right. CMRR, is what? AD upon AC. Have you written this? So what will be the value of CMRR? So this is one of the first approximations of CMRR. There are one or two more formulas for it, but more or less are same. AD upon, what was AD? Minus 2 RD 1 by GM1 plus 1 by GM2 upon what we had here, minus RD by 2 upon 1 upon GM1 parallel with generic. Barar ki nahi? So now you open this whole thing and you calculate what is CMR. That is minus 2 RD upon GM1 plus GM2. Here we'll have GM1, GM2, this entire thing upon RD by 2. So RD gets cancelled off, actually speaking, upon GM1, GM2 upon GM1 plus GM2 plus R. So now you cross multiply. So this goes away. Minus 4 GM1 GM2 upon what will you get? Upon what? 1 plus RSS So just cross multiply and tell me what is the answer. This will be up, no? So this upon this, just solve that. Whatever you get, you write. Yes. So something I was. So should it be reverse? Here, no? This will be what? How? That will be what? 1 upon GM1 plus GM2, that's right. So this will be 1 upon plus RSS like this. Okay, so some mistake. So now you can expand this. So I think RD will cancel out and we'll get to like this. This will become 4. Check it. I think now it's on. 2 will go up, it will become 4. RD, RD cancels out. GM1 plus GM2 by 2, that will also go. And here it will be GM1 plus GM2 into RS. That's fine. That's your value of CMRR. And if RSS is too high, then CMRR is high. But if RSS is something, then CMRR can be computed like directly from the W by L of the transistor. Bararkin, why you can compute directly? GM1 is what? Root of 2 mu n COA W by L times of I1 or I2. And I1 is nothing but ISS by 2. So W by L is given. I1 is ISS by 2 always. Why? Because same currents are flowing through M1 and because both are same, having same input. And this ISS formula we again have. What is that? W by L 3 upon W by L 4 into IRS. So in a way, it's just a matter of designing the current. So again, GM1 and GM2 also depend on the value of the current source. Yes or no? Depend on the value of the current. So everything is linked to that. So you find out the value of the current source, you should be able to calculate the value of GM1 and GM2. Now if both are equal, then what will this become? 4 GM square upon 1 plus 2 GMR. So if you start dividing by GM square in both numerator and denominator, what will you get? Here you will get 1 by GM. So no need, whatever you get, you just write. Okay? Theek hai, we'll stop.